A former Supreme Court Associate Justice recommends putting civilian presence in the West Philippine Sea to counter Chinese aggression. Antonio Carpio says the Philippines can't go to the International Tribunal to protest China's escalating dangerous acts since the body has no jurisdiction over military activities. Carpio believes even if China stops civilian activities in Philippine waters, the International Court will still side with Manila and issue another arbitral award.
Yung ginawa ng Chinese Coast Guard, that's against international law. Dahil itong all warships have sovereign immunity. Extension yan ng sovereignty of a state. Ang recommendation ko, palitan natin yung presence natin from military to civilian. Magtatayo tayo ng lighthouse operated by the Coast Guard. Civilian kasi ang Coast Guard eh. At saka magkaroon ng substation ng Coast Guard doon, let's say magkaroon ng research center ang UP, so civilian talaga. Hihintuin yan ng China, no? Pagdala natin ng mga materials to construct, hintuin yan. Pero pag hinintuyan ng China, we can go to the tribunal na this is a civilian activity.
Carpio also has this to say on calls to expel Chinese diplomats in the Philippines.
Pwede yun. We can start with the lower echelon, mga deputy ambassador. Pero huwag muna yung ambassador dahil ano yan, reserve that for very serious disputes.
Senator Sherwin Gatchalian reveals the Senate is working with the Chinese embassy to determine the real citizenship of controversial Bamban Tarlac Mayor Alice Go. Gatchalian earlier bared new documents of a certain Go Hua Ping, which he believes is the real identity of the Bamban mayor. Gatchalian says it will be easy for the Chinese government to identify her since Mayor Go also has a Chinese passport.
The committee is already doing that. In fact, we sent letter to the committee to already initiate proceedings coordinating with the Chinese embassy. I understand there are protocols that we have to go through the Department of Foreign Affairs. We cannot go straight to the Chinese embassy because of these protocols, but we are coordinating and getting relevant information. We also have records that between 2008 and 2011, Alice Go and Guo Huaping flew to China using different passports.
Meanwhile, Senator Gatchalian hopes a quo warranto case against the mayor will be filed soon to stop her from running in the midterm polls. Go earlier said she plans to seek re-election.
All of these pieces of evidence that we gathered should be used by the Office of the Solicitor General in their filing of a quo warranto case. That will send a signal to those who are thinking of doing the abusing the late registration process and eventually running for public office. I hope someone in Banban, at least one out of that 50,000, will file a case to challenge her citizenship.
Yeah.
Because it's true that COMELEC is ministerial in the receiving of the certificate of candidacy, but the COMELEC will be triggered to investigate if someone from Banban, a registered voter, will challenge her citizenship. And I'm sure there will be.
In an election standing by, the reliability of the automated counting machines that will be used in next year's polls, as well as the company behind it. The commission also unveiling a new batch of policies that aim to instill discipline among candidates. Sherian Torres reports.
Right now, Commission on Elections Chairman George Irwin Garcia demonstrated how automated counting machine will be used in next year's polls during AMAC voting at ANC program Head Start. ABS-CBN anchor Karen Davila was asked to fill a ballot paper, which was later fed to the ACM. The ACM then showed the list of candidates she voted for. It later released a voting receipt with a QR code, which needs to be dropped to the voting receipt receptacle. Garcia says the voter or the poll watcher are not allowed to take a photo of the accomplished ballot or voting receipt. Doing so opens them up to possible charges. On election day, a voter will be able to see an image of the ballot flashed on the screen. Poll officials also rule out the possibility of a fake or pre-filled ballots being fed to the machine.
Sa simula pa lang, yung gagawin po ng ating teachers, una papakita yung ballot box sa MP, ilalagay yung takip. Pag na-imount na po yung makina, na-re-zero siya and all, lahat po yan ay sa-serial. So hindi na po tatanggalin yan. Bubuksan na lamang, bubibreak open ng seal na yan kapag pinatawag po ng korte o ng COMELEC sa isang election protest. Hindi po yan gagalawin, hindi yan babalihin unless may order po ang komisyon o kaya po ang mga korte.
Meantime, Garcia dismisses criticisms hurled against South Korean firm Miro System. The poll chief maintains the technology firm was able to meet their demands and the company showed it can deliver the needed machines. This comes after COMELEC officials and other stakeholders inspected Miro's factory in South Korea. Miro Systems, for its part, says they will continue to show transparency as they move forward with their responsibility for the upcoming elections. Meantime, the COMELEC and Bank has approved the proposal directing candidates in the 2025 midterm elections to only use biodegradable materials for their campaign paraphernalia. Candidates are also prohibited from using loud communication systems and other hazardous materials in their campaign activities.
The sense is there has to be a sanction. We will see if it's going to be workable that it's part either of the certificate of candidacy, or if not, then it is a pledge that we are going to put up at the filing that, you know, we'll ask them to sign, or it's available for them to sign voluntarily. So in that sense, also call it a soft law, you know. People, it will be enforced by what? By publicity, and people publicly will see, does this candidate support this initiative by signing or not? And that will impact also on his environmental bona fides for the public.
Eco-Waste Coalition and Environmental Protection Watchdog welcomed the Commission's policy, saying they have long been advocating for environment-friendly elections.
Dahil may bagong nilabas na advisory nga ang COMELEC, ay maaari at mas magandang tignan na parang randomly ay titignan natin kung sino talaga yung sumusunod at hindi sumusunod at eto-call out natin yung pangalan na yan.
The Commission and Bank also gives its green light to post on the COMELEC website the certificates of candidacy and certificates of nomination and acceptance, or CONA, of all national and local candidates in next year's elections. Sherian Torres, ABS-CBN News.